Recently, the Energy Conservation Act was amended. Section 14AA was introduced in Energy Conservation Act, which provides for carbon credits. So, Government of India, keeping in view Section 14AA of the Energy Conservation Act, released a document which is called Carbon Credit Trading Scheme 2023. Let us understand what is this Carbon Credit Trading Scheme 2023.
For mitigating climate change, carbon markets are very important. The Government of India has recently released Carbon Credit Trading Scheme 2023. Kindly shed light on it, sir.
Rijab Namaskar and Tila Pranam. So, a lot of companies have come up with the query that they want to become a carbon trading company. Carbon trading company ka kya kaam hai? Char kaam hote carbon trading company ke. Number one, find a project. So, अगर कोई प्रोजेक्ट प्रोपोनेंट है विच कैन हेल्प इन कार्बन ट्रेडिंग और विच कैन जनरेट कार्बन क्रेडिट, दैट इज द फर्स्ट स्टेप. सेकेंड स्टेप इज रजिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट. सो हेल्पिंग दीज कंपनीज, रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी कंपनीज और कंपनीज हु कैन जनरेट कार्बन क्रेडिट टू गेट रजिस्टर्ड इन द फोरम और प्लेटफॉर्म, दैट इज द सेकेंड वर्क ऑफ कार्बन ट्रेडिंग कंपनी. थर्ड वर्क ऑफ कार्बन ट्रेडिंग कंपनी इज getting it audited by third party auditors. So, जो भी projects होते हैं which are generating carbon credits, they have to be audited by third party operators or third party auditors. And fourth is source buyers. So, there have to be buyers. So, buyer-seller negotiations and to determine fair price. This is the work. So, fourfold work is of the carbon trading company. Recently, Government of India has launched Carbon Credit Trading Scheme 2023. So, Carbon Credit Trading Scheme 2023 creates an express way for decarbonization of the world. And Carbon Credit Trading Scheme ke andar mein 2023 ki jo hai, carbon credit certificates are issued. So, the Energy Conservation Act was it, the original act is 2001, Energy Conservation Act 2001. Recently, the Energy Conservation Act was amended. A section 14AA was introduced in Energy Conservation Act, which provides for carbon credits. So, Government of India, keeping in view section 14AA of the Energy Conservation Act, released a document which is called Carbon Credit Trading Scheme 2023. Let us understand what is this Carbon Credit Trading Scheme 2023. First of all, the Carbon Credit Trading Scheme provides for a National Steering Committee. The National Steering Committee will create policy for the carbon trading market in India. Who will be the members of National Steering Committee? Number one, the Power Secretary will be the chairperson. The Environment Secretary will be the Vice Chairperson. Members will be first Joint Secretary Finance, Niti Aayog, Joint Secretary Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, Joint Secretary Ministry of Steel, Joint Secretary Ministry of Coal, Joint Secretary Ministry of Chemicals and Fertilizers, Joint Secretary Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas, Joint Secretary Ministry of Agriculture. Two principal secretaries of two states will also be included in the steering committee. Two expert members will be included who have expertise in the carbon market. The chairperson, Central Electricity Authority, will also be the member of the steering committee. Chairperson and managing director of Grid Controller of India will also be the member. Three members can be co-opted by the National Steering Committee to become member. The secretarial assistance will be provided by Director General of Bureau of Energy Efficiency. So, this is the composition of policy making body for the carbon markets in India. So, if somebody says who will make policy for the carbon market of India or who will steer or guide the carbon market of India, then it is the National Steering Committee under the Carbon Credit Trading Scheme 2023. On what things the National Steering Committee will make policy? First is, the National Steering Committee will provide, number one, greenhouse gases emission targets. It will specify the targets. Secondly, the National Steering Committee will provide guidelines for inter-country exchange of carbon trading. So, if a European company or American company wants to purchase carbon credits from India, then this national steering committee will provide the guidelines. Third thing which the national steering committee will provide, monitoring and reporting and verification, MRV jisko bolte, monitoring, reporting and verification, how it will be done for the carbon markets in India. So after understanding what is the carbon credit trading scheme policy making body, let us understand which are the actors in the carbon market of India. Firstly, the administrator of the Indian carbon market is BEE, Bureau of Energy Efficiency. So Bureau of Energy Efficiency, Bureau of Energy Efficiency as administrator, number one, it will do research and identify sectors jahan pe the capping will be provided with respect to issue of carbon credits. Secondly, the Bureau of Energy Efficiency will do research and identify trajectory and targets for the carbon market. Third, the Bureau of Energy Efficiency will develop market stability mechanisms. So this is the work of BEE as administrator. BEE as administrator also will certify carbon verification agency. Jo third party agencies hote hain, unka verification, you can call it accreditation of carbon verification agency, will be done by Bureau of Energy Efficiency. So first important player, besides the policy making body, as administrator, BEE will function. Second important player, so the question will come, who will be the registry of the carbon credits in India? So the registry as per the scheme of carbon credits in India will be Grid Controller of India. As a registry, Grid Controller of India will be meta registry for India. Features of establishing linkages with international registries of any market based mechanism will be done by Grid Controller of India. Grid Controller of India will also have the list of obligated entities jinko compulsory hai work karna carbon market mein, and non-obligated entities. So there are two kinds of market in India which will be created. One is the voluntary market and one is compliance market. So simply said, in voluntary market, jo bhi climate change ko mitigate karna chahti hai, koi bhi company, it can be IT company, information technology company, it can buy carbon credits from voluntary market. It is not a compulsion to it. Lekin ek compulsory market bhi hoga, jahan pe there will be obligated entities. Those obligated entities may be a steel plant, they may be a fertilizer plant, they may be cement plant who require a lot of energy. So they may become obligated entity. Unki jo listing hai, wo registry maintain karegi, and that is Grid Controller of India. Third important player in the carbon market is the regulator. So Central Electricity Regulatory Commission has been identified as the regulator for carbon markets in India. And as a regulator, the Central Electricity Regulatory Commission will ensure there is no fraud in the carbon market in India, and it will make regulations for the same. Besides avoiding, preventing fraud and making regulations, the Central Electricity Regulatory Commission as a regulator will also register power exchanges jahan pe carbon trading hogi. So as of now, there are three power exchanges which have been registered by Central Electricity Regulatory Commission, and the three power exchanges are IEX, Indian Energy Exchange, PXIL, Power Exchange of India Limited, and HPEL, Hindustan Power Exchange Limited. So already three power exchanges are existing in India. The Central Electricity Regulatory Commission can register these exchanges for carbon markets, or may register additional exchanges for the carbon markets. So to sum it up, Indian carbon markets policy making body is National Steering Committee. National Steering Committee is an interdepartmental committee where secretaries, joint secretaries and members will constitute a National Steering Committee. It will make policies with respect to greenhouse gases emission targets, and it will specify the targets. Secondly, there are three important players. One is Bureau of Energy Efficiency as administrator, which will also do accreditation of carbon verification agencies. Second is Grid Controller of India will be registry, and it will be the registrar, which will also register obligated entities and non-obligated entities. Third is Central Electricity Regulatory Commission will be the regulator, which will also register power exchanges or exchanges for carbon markets.